Welcome, Lake Howell High School, to your Hawk News.
Hello everyone, welcome to the Hawks News Nest. I'm Julian Henry.
And I'm Sean Lavin. The National Honor Society Pasta for Pennies donation will end this week. All proceeds go to the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society, and all donations are greatly appreciated. The seventh period that raises the most money will receive a free Olive Garden lunch, and the second place class will receive a free donut party.
Congratulations to the Lake Howell Varsity Winter Guard for coming in fourth in the Scholastic A class at the WGI Tampa Regional Competition last weekend. The Winter Guard is currently ranked 24th in the country out of all the Scholastic A class guards advancing to nationals in April.
Student government will be collecting hygiene items for the families in transition drive. Bring hygiene items like shampoo, conditioner, soap powder, razors, toothpaste, deodorant, sanitary wipes, paper towels, and toilet paper to your second period class. All items donated will be collected and given to our local families in need. The second period class that collects the most items per student will win a complimentary Panera breakfast.
Boys volleyball will be holding a car wash tomorrow from 10 to 2 at the 7-Eleven on Tuscarawas in Aloma. The boys will be selling pre-sale tickets this entire week.
Coming up on the Hawks News Nest, the spring sports are in full swing.
And we'll have your forecast for the weekend. We'll be right back.
Hi, my name is Ethan Sawyer, your local celebrity endorsement, here to tell you about the faculty versus student basketball game. It's going to be happening March 30th. At 7 p.m. in the main gym. Now, go hard and go fast, Silverhawks. Caw!
Zachary Sports. The Silverhawks softball team traveled to downtown Orlando Tuesday night to take on Boone. The Hawks had the early lead in the fourth with Giovanna Watts homer, but Boone tied it in the fifth. Thanks to Rachel Kutcher's seven solid innings, the game stayed tied until the bottom of the eighth, where Boone got the winning run. The Hawks then took on Hagerty last night, and we will have the result on our Twitter page and on Tuesday. The baseball team dodged the raindrops Wednesday night to take on Lyman at the field. Matt Levinson did the damage with a two-run double, and that was a difference as the Hawks beat the Greyhounds 3-1. If you are looking for something to do tonight, the baseball team will take on DeLand here at the Silverhawk Field. The game will start at 7. Boys and girls lacrosse had a huge district matchup this week. The boys took on Oviedo Wednesday night, but came up short 13-2. The Hawks will also take on East River tonight at the stadium. We will have full coverage of the game on Tuesday, along with a special surprise for you on Tuesday. You'll have to tune in to find out. After losing to Edgewater on Monday, the girls looked to bounce back last night against Lyman. We'll have the result on our Twitter page. Girls water polo got the best win of the week by dominating Oviedo 10-2. Jacqueline Childers had 3 goals and 4 assists in the win. The boys fought hard but lost to Oviedo 13-12. Noah Reif was a bright spot for the Hawks with 6 goals. Both teams were in the pool last night against Wakaiba, and we will have the result on our Twitter page. The boys and girls tennis teams hit the courts last night against the Geneva School, and again, we will have a result on our Twitter page. And finally, Josh Scholl, David Mello, Justin Segura, Ricky Washington, and Angel Giraldo will all compete in the wrestling regional tournament this weekend in Palm Coast. Wish them luck as they try to qualify for the state meet next weekend in Kissimmee. That's it for sports. Now back to the studio. Go Hawks! We'll be right back.
morning, Silverhawks. I'm back at my old location since I can't travel too far without getting frostbite in these chilly temperatures. Once again, I'm Marissa Stalteri. Today it's going to be cold, tomorrow's cold, and this weekend is going to be freezing cold. So be sure you bundle up and cuddle with your teddy bears because you can't bear this cold weather. That's it for your forecast, Silverhawks. I'll catch you guys back here next week, but for now, I'm going to bring it back to the studio.
Thank you for watching the Hawks News Nest. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at LHHS News Nest for breaking Silverhawk news. Now stay tuned for Alma Mater.
Have a great day, Silverhawks.